Protective supplies and space. Those are the two things in demand, but not always available as the state continues to manage the COVID-19 crisis. KETK State Capitol reporter Wes Rappaport caught up with the governor and Texas emergency managers today as they visited a hotbed of need and promised to stay well stocked.
Even though we're in a comfortable place, we don't know how long this is going to take.
Doctors like Leighton Ellis are cautiously optimistic the personal protective equipment supply chain is getting restored.
We definitely have enough hand sanitizer now, thanks to all the distilleries.
Touring a state warehouse Tuesday, the governor said the state has distributed millions of masks, gloves, gowns, and face shields.
We have abundant supplies to make sure that we will be able to continue to provide PPE to schools, to hospitals, to nursing homes, to testing sites, to any operation in the state of Texas.
But some schools and doctors say they don't always get everything they've requested right away.
We are getting PPE that comes in, but it tends to be in restricted quantities. So you might get, 20-25% of what you ordered. It might take a little bit longer to come in. So we do still have to be careful about rationing supplies.
While the state works to keep up with supplies here in its biggest distribution warehouse in San Antonio, the Rio Grande Valley faces other challenges beyond the supplies. Hospitals are so overrun there, the McAllen Convention Center had to open up for its first patient Tuesday. The governor paid that alternative care site a visit as well.
This is going to be a very effective relief valve as needed for local hospitals, whether it be in Hidalgo County or the surrounding counties, to make sure that hospitals will not be overloaded.
Local leaders are setting up a similar site in nearby Harlingen. Wes Rappaport, KETK News.
The Texas Division of Emergency Management tells us any supplies that are not needed for the COVID-19 response may end up stockpiled at those warehouses to be used for other public health needs in the future.